Hello, and welcome to the TI High-Speed Data Converter Lab that will help a user understand the difference between a data converter sample rate versus data rate. In this video, we will explain the difference between these two commonly used terms, along with a high-level explanation of decimation and interpolation, which, due to these two digital data processing techniques either decrease or increase the converter data rate. This video will cover data converter input and sample data rates, digital down converters or DDC that will perform decimation, digital up converters or DUC that will perform interpolation, key advantages and disadvantages to using these functions, and a brief section on JSD 204B SERDES rates and how they are related to the data converter sample and data rates. The sample rate is the speed at which an ADC data converter is sampling an analog input or a DAC data converter is sending out an analog output. This rate is usually the external clock rate that is supplied to these converters. Some of the new converters, though, such as the TI-DAC38J84 and other parts in this family, have internal PLLs that provide an option to create the high-speed sample clock using a slower input clock. This sometimes confuses the user when they enter the sample rate information in the GUIs used by our customer EVMs. The data rate is the rate of the digital output data from an ADC or a digital input data rate to a DAC. In many cases, these are not the same rate as the sample clock. For example, if a user was operating an ADS54J60 ADC in decimation by 2 mode at a sample rate of 1 gigasamples per second, the actual data rate leaving the device will be 1 gigasamples per second divided by 2, or 500 megasamples per second. If the user was using decimate by 4 mode, this would be 250 megasamples per second. Keep in mind that this is the equivalent parallel data rate and not the SERDES rate of the output pins of this device. This will be discussed later in this video. With the new higher sampling data converters, higher data rates are required. In many cases, these rates are too high for the data converter device or the FPGA ASIC that is receiving or deriving the data to the data converter. Another reason may be the number of IOs available. In either case, the data rate usually needs to be reduced. And to do this, interpolation and decimation are used. When using decimation or interpolation, a good rule of thumb is to select a data rate that can support the bandwidth of the signal and a sample rate that can support spectral purity. In this next section, we will discuss decimation concepts. This will include a definition, time versus frequency comparison, advantages and disadvantages, and some example TI parts that are using decimation. What exactly is decimation? In digital signal processing, decimation is the process of reducing the sample rate of a signal. The term downsampling usually refers to one step of the process, but sometimes the terms are used interchangeably. Complementary to upsampling or interpolation, which increases sampling rate, decimation is a specific case of sample rate conversion in a multi-rate digital signal processing system. When decimation is performed on a sequence of samples of a signal or other continuous function, it produces an approximation of the sequence that would have been obtained by sampling the signal at a lower rate. This is accomplished by removing samples from the data stream. Decimation will usually include a digital low-pass or anti-aliasing filter followed by the decimator. This operation is like using an analog anti-aliasing filter at a center frequency equal to the sample rate divided by the decimation factor. A decimation factor is usually an integer or a rational fraction greater than 1. This factor divides the sampling rate, or can be equivalent to multiplying this number by the output data rate to determine the actual sampling rate used by the ADC. Decimation is used to decrease the sample rate to levels that the device can handle, allows for high sampling rates for more flexible frequency planning, and filtering that provides improved spectral performance. In this slide, an example of a decimation function is shown in both the time domain and frequency domain. When decimation is performed, images are created as shown in the frequency domain plots. The signal and images around the sample rate of the converter will shift down to the sample rate divided by 2 in this example. The signal and images at 2FS will shift down to FS and so on. Low-pass filters are then used to provide anti-aliasing protection, which will remove these images and allow for a clean spectrum at a much lower data rate. Data sheets usually include block diagrams showing the functions available of the DDC. This slide is showing an example of the DDC functions available inside the ADS54J60 ADC from TI. As you can see from this diagram, this part offers several functions, including a decimate by 2 mode, decimate by 4 mode, mixer shift option followed by decimate by 4 block, and a DDC bypass mode. As mentioned early, decimation is accompanied by filtering, as can be seen in this block diagram. This part has options for a low-pass filter or high-pass filter in decimate by 2 mode. In decimate by 4 mode, it offers 4 different center frequency options for the bandpass filter. Using decimation has advantages as well as some disadvantages. The advantages are it will provide SNR processing gain, the frequency domain view of the signal remains constant, the noise power is reduced by the decimation filter, SNR performance improves, and due to averaging samples, the overall noise of the converter is reduced. Using decimation, though, does not come without some cost. Some of the disadvantages are more digital logic is required. Using more digital logic will cost more power, and the overall signal bandwidth capability will be reduced. Some examples of TI parts that have an internal decimation function are shown in this slide. The ADC32R45 family, which is a dual-channel 14-bit 3 gigasamples per second ADC, has several decimation options from 4x all the way up to 32x. The ADC12J4000 family is a single converter with options from 4x to 32x, whereas the ADS54J60 family only offers 2x and 4x decimation. In this next section, we will discuss interpolation concepts. This will include a definition, time domain view, frequency domain view, advantages and disadvantages, and some example TI parts that are using interpolation. What exactly is interpolation? In digital signal processing, interpolation, or upsampling, is the process of increasing the sampling rate of a signal without affecting the signal itself. Interpolation is a method of constructing new data points within the range of a discrete set of known data points. The typical method used to perform interpolation is as follows. Insert a logic zero between each sample. This is known as zero stuffing or upsampling. Filter the resulting images created from the upsample process. This would create a 2x interpolation. To get 4x interpolation, repeat this process again. For 8x, repeat again, and so on. This cascading method is preferred as it increases the efficiency of the required half-band filters. With interpolation, the DAC output rate can be increased. The images can be shifted further from the desired band of interest, which allows for a wider Nyquist zone and maintain reasonable digital data rates to the DAC. This slide is showing the function of interpolation in the time domain. This example shows three zeros being inserted between the original samples. Adding zeros does not change the spectral content of the signal. It just widens the bandwidth. Then, using filtering, such as a low-pass filter, the samples that were added are adjusted to fill in the missing levels between the actual samples, as shown in the bottom diagram. This next slide is showing a frequency domain view of the interpolation. The top diagram is a typical output of a digital up converter after zeros have been added to the original data, but before any filtering is applied. The second diagram is showing the effects of a 2x interpolation low-pass filter. This filter will be used to attenuate the data images that are around F data. Normally, if decimation greater than 2 is required, it will be done in stages. The third diagram is showing the effects of a second 2x interpolation stage to use in the signal chain to perform 4x interpolation. The fourth diagram is then showing the results after the second low-pass filter of the second stage. Using these two low-pass filters allows for an unchanged output tone but at a much higher sampling rate, as shown in the bottom diagram. Now, if desired, the user can shift this original signal to a much higher intermediate frequency, or IF, using a numerically controlled oscillator, or NCO, with minimal performance degradation. Data sheets should show the full filter response of the interpolation filters of the device. Figure 60 and figure 61 in this slide show the magnitude spectrum response for the FIR0 and FIR1 interpolating filters used by the DAC38J84 device. The x-axis uses a normalized scale for the input data rate to the FIR filter. Other figures that can be found in data sheets include the composite filter response for the entire cascaded interpolation blocks used. Note that there will be a loss of signal amplitude as the frequency of interest approaches the knee of the filters, which will result in a lower SNR. Also, using multiple FIR filters will add latency to the data path. These latency numbers are usually listed in the datasheet. Using interpolation has advantages as well as some disadvantages. The advantages are it will shift the DAC images further from the band of interest, thus making it easier to filter the output. It will allow for a wider Nyquist zone for flexible frequency planning, reduce the noise spectral density, lower the required input data rate, and achieve higher output sample rates. Using interpolation, though, does not come without some cost. Some of the disadvantages are more digital logic is required. Using more digital logic will cost more power and will add latency. And the input bandwidth will be limited by the interpolation filters. One example of a DAC device from TI that has an internal interpolation function is the DAC38RF80. As shown in this slide, this function allows for several different interpolation rates. Other parts in this family actually have more options. This table also shows the user which filters are used to create the individual interpolation rate. These next slides will discuss the sampling of newer high-speed data converters that are using the JSD-204B standard. JSD-204B is a standardized serial interface between data converters and logic devices, such as FPGAs or ASICs, and is used by most of the new high-speed data converters being developed today. With this new standard, JSD-204B parts are easily sampling in the gigahertz range. Some of the newer RF DACs can sample up to 9 gigasamples per second. Sampling at this rate has its drawbacks, as this would require input data rates in ranges up to 90 gigabits per second per SerDes lanes. Since the JSD-204B standard can only support rates up to 12.5 gigasamples per second, the data rate must be lowered. To accomplish this, interpolation is used. Many of the JSD DACs have several options to choose from regarding the interpolation factor. This allows the user options when it comes to choosing how many SerDes lanes they will need and how fast these will operate at. This is not as much a problem with current JSD-204B ADC converters, as they are not sampling as fast. But if the user would like to reduce the number of lanes, then this becomes a problem and decimation would be required. In this example, we show a DAC 38J84 that will use all four DACs, 8 SerDes lanes, interpolation factor of 4, and a maximum DAC sample rate of 2.5 gigabits per second. To determine if the SerDes rate will fall within the spec of the JSD-204B standard, we will do the following calculations. First, we will convert the octets used in the JSD-204B into bits. Since each sample comprises of 2 octets, there will be 12,500 megaoctets per sample per DAC. JSD-204B uses 8B10B encoding. Each octet will consist of 10 bits, so this then comes out to be 12,500 megabits per second. Now the total bit rate is 12,500 megabits per second times 4 DACs, which is equal to 50 gigabits per second. To get this below 12.5 gigabits per second, we choose 8 SerDes lanes to bring this down to 6.25 gigabits per second. Another option would be to use 4 lanes, which we would have this at 12.5 gigabits per second. This is where a customer would have a trade-off to make. Use more lanes at a slower speed, or less at a much higher rate. They could not use less than 4 lanes, as this would exceed the SerDes data rate of the JSD-204B spec. In this slide, you will see a table showing the minimum and maximum sample rates that can be used by this DAC. F data is the rate parallel data is leaving the JSD-204B block and feeding the digital input block of the DAC. FDAC is the actual sample rate of the DAC. FDAC is equal to FData times the interpolation factor. Since the SerDes outputs use an internal PLL, they will have a minimum as well as a maximum operating range. Due to this, the JSD-204B data converters have a relatively high minimum sample rate. In many cases, to use the maximum sample rate, the user must use some interpolation to get the SerDes rate down below the 12.5 gigabits per second. That is the maximum allowed by the JSD-204B standard. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching.